Welcome to the local music show with myself, John Sinclair, and Kevin Gaughan. Kevin's not here today, but you will hear him because he's been talking to the group Skam. That's come later, and this probably sounds familiar. It's a band I'm very fond of, and it's good to welcome Sam from Beneath the Lights onto the phone. Hi, Sam, how are you doing?
Hi, not too bad. Yourself?
Yeah, good to talk to you. I think last time the lads came in, you weren't able to make it, so we're kind of making up for that a little bit as well, I think.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I was busy working. Some of us have to
do that, don't we?
Yeah, of course.
But it's been a busy year for you, hasn't it, really?
Yeah, I mean, this year's been fantastic. You know, we've had Brandon in now for this year, and we've just been playing show after show and hearing such good feedback and just really enjoying it.
Yeah, festival-wise, I suppose things like Glaston Budget and stuff, what sticks out for you?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they're just such a big weekend of events. And, you know, you see all the best local Leicester musicians there as well. You know, we've got loads of friends playing there now, and it's just such a good laugh.
And you're mad. Just reminds those in the band as well, for those that don't know, because you've got a mad guitarist as well, haven't you?
Yeah, we have a bassist called Harry Burry. And if you've ever seen us, I mean, I don't know, he can't stand still. He looks like he's got an issue, but he is incredible, and he is one of the best bassists I know as well, so even better.
It's always good. It kind of like, you can focus on the singing, obviously, but people have got something to focus on because he's all over the place on stage. But I guess bands do need something different like that as well, don't they, to kind of stick out?
Yeah, it's just, we just try to keep it really high energy and, you know, get the crowd involved as much as we can and just, you know, it's all about having a good time at the end of the day. We just want everyone to enjoy our music and, you know, get a bit of a party on, so.
I think you had a last minute gig at the weekend, didn't you, as well?
Last night was very short notice. We got rang up about 9 o'clock the night before and they're like, yeah, do you want to play a gig tomorrow? It's one of the local pubs around where we live, and yeah, we're all free and we're all back from uni to practice anyway and write new music for the album. So we said yeah, basically, and it was really good turnout. So if anyone's listening, just thank them for coming down because they made it such a great night.
Now, I remember voting for you for something to do with Strawberry Fields. I think you just explain how it works. So I think you just dropped agonisingly short of the amount you wanted, didn't you?
Yeah, last year it was a 2 week span of voting online, and we just happened to lose by roughly 20 votes. But we were really surprised to get over 900 last year. We're actually a little bit shocked, but a little bit gutted in the end as well because it was by such a close margin. But we went and saw the Barmines who played there anyway, and it looked like a good weekend. But it's actually come around again this year. So there's now a new poll on the Facebook page of Strawberry Fields where you can vote for your favourite bands. And we are just tipping it at the minute, but there are some bands closely following. So, you know, any support would be much appreciated, but, you know, vote for your favourite bands in that.
Yeah, it's good to be able to break into festivals. I think a few people have targeted Strawberry Fields because you're used to Glaston Budget, but you want to kind of, you know, I went to the one you did at Colville, didn't I, as well, which is quite a good one as well. But Strawberry Fields is an ambition for a few bands, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, there's some artists that have played there that, you know, really got big names for themselves now, and it's just another step. It's another big festival, and it seems to be a great weekend. So we'd love to play it, if I'm honest.
Yeah, I'm just looking at your Facebook site here. You've got a few gigs coming up. We are in December now, aren't we? Oh, goodness me.
Yeah.
Where's the year gone? I think you've got one on the 13th of December with 8 Miles High, who we've had in the studio recently. They played Glaston Budget as well, didn't they?
Yeah, they are our partners in crime, I'm afraid. They are our best friends.
I think they say the same about you.
They probably say very derogatory things, but, you know, we love those guys, and, you know, they're such good, talented musicians as well. And we just get on, and, you know, if we can book a gig together, we'll happily, you know, try and work on that and get more gigs together because it's always a fun night.
Have you auditioned for Glaston Budget as well? Is that on the cards? Have you done that already?
Yeah. We auditioned quite early again this year. The audition went really well. So fingers crossed and just hope for the best because, you know, sometimes, you know, it's called a new act stage. I don't know. Sometimes, you know, we wonder if we're going to get in for a fourth year running. But, you know, we'd really love to. It's such a good weekend. I know Joe, the drummer, definitely loves it. It's his favourite time of the year, I think.
And you're all working around education as well, aren't you? Universities. How is that kind of working?
It's not going as bad as I thought it'd be. I thought when we had to start uni, we'd have to kind of drop the band a little bit, if I'm honest. But the three of us, me, Harry and Joe, are all in the second year of university. I'm based in Sheffield, Joe's in Northampton, Harry's stayed in Leicester. So getting back can seem to be difficult, but we're doing all right at the minute. And if we've got a free weekend and we've not got a gig, you know, at the minute we're home at the weekends practicing and writing new songs for the album that we're recording over Christmas.
And I noticed a picture on your website to do with Jones's album launch. He's a bit of a character, the local rapper, isn't he? He's always at gigs. If he's not on stage, he's watching bands, isn't he?
Definitely. He's such a lovely lad. And, you know, we like playing with him, and we've been with him a few times now. But, yeah, he asked us to support his album launch, and it was a really good night for him. So all the best with his music.
You gave it glowing references, I think, after the day, didn't you? I think you lots of big write-ups.
Yeah, definitely. No, it was a good night, so definitely one to think about.
So you're going to have a good Christmas now, then, are you? A few gigs, go out to a few parties, and then think about next year. But recording-wise, where are you with that?
Well, at the minute, I'm just setting up some guide tracks at home in Sheffield, just to try and get it all settled and ready, and, you know, if we want to add any extra bits in. But we've booked 4 days in the studio towards the end of December, beginning of January, and we're hoping to make a full album this time around, because the last one was obviously a two-single EP, and we just want to give a bit more.
Are you getting out in Sheffield to watch bands as well?
I have been out and about recently to see a few of my favourite bands, like Mallory Knox and A Day to Remember, and bands like that. I haven't been to many local scenes recently, but we're just trying to push ourselves out at the minute, out of Leicester, and kind of spread the word. And I mean, we've got a gig at the Bourne Corn Exchange on the 19th December as well, and we've now booked a gig in Leeds, I know of, for next year.
Okay,
on the 7th of February.
I think that's what most bands talk about, isn't it? Trying to kind of spread their wings and get to play out of the county as well.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's how you spread the music, isn't it? Got to get people on your side, I guess.
Indeed. Okay, we're going to play the whole of Broken Town. So, is this about a town you know that's broken?
Well, without being too derogatory, our town from where we're from was looking a bit poor.
Yeah.
A few years ago, we've got a few rundown pubs and things like that, and it's not all quite as pleasant as everyone would love it to be. But
yeah,
we're working on things in the local community to get it better.
Maybe you need another song called Spruce Up the Town or something.
Definitely.
Okay, Sam, good to talk to you. I'll try and catch you at
too.
A gig. Try and catch you at a gig shortly. And have a good week. Have a good Christmas as well. Thanks
Definitely.
Very much.
Thank you very much.
Okay,
and
here's Broken Town.
Cheers.
Up off the ground, and I don't like to stay.
Nice to hear from Sam from Beneath the Lights, and reminded they're playing the 13th of December at the Soundhouse with another excellent band they're very big friends with, 8 Miles High. So that's Beneath the Lights. Check them out. Look forward to hearing their new material in the new year as well. Right, we've got an interview with Skam coming up that Kevin did last week. He went to see them at a gig. They got a new drummer now, so he decided to have a chat with them about what that's brought to the group, how it's kind of changed things. Before that, I'm going to mention the Paradigms, because they've got a great gig on Saturday supporting Aswad at Street Life. Dawn Penn and Echo Marley are also on the lineup as well. Should be a fantastic night, that. I always like playing a bit of Paradigm, so an excuse to play Bedroom Mazooka. So check them out at Street Life this week with the likes of Aswad. I think I might have to ask for a ticket for that. It's one of my favourite tracks of theirs. The Paradigms and Bedroom Mazooka, and Gary, who plays trumpet, joins us on the line now. I do like that one, Gary.
That's one of your favourites, isn't it, John?
It is. I just can't stop playing it. Any excuse. And I've got it
on.
It's one of those.
It's always, it's track number one as well, so when you give people the album, they rarely get past that track. That one.
I've just been talking about Saturday. It's a big night for you, isn't it, with the likes of Aswad and Dawn Penn and so on.
Yeah, Saturday the 13th it is, yeah. So it's a week this coming Saturday. Huge night. It's an honour to play with obviously Aswad, who are a British reggae band who've done something. You know, they've got a real long, prestigious career behind them. So, and it's in tune with what we're doing at the moment, having just done the 100 Club and Skarmouth as well. So we're really enjoying ourselves at the moment.
Yeah, actually, I think I misread it. So it's a week on Saturday, not this Saturday.
Week on Saturday, yeah. Saturday the 13th of December at Street Life. And,
yeah,
it's me, available from iwanttickets.com.
It's me not being able to read my phone again. that's what it is. But actually, last time we met, we talked about the Funk Nation night. In town, and I DJ'd a recent gig for you there, didn't I?
That's right, yeah, the Haggis Horns gig,
yeah. And the musician, yeah. And actually, what I got there early, ended up playing for 2 hours, eight till ten,
right.
Yeah, well, the other DJ, I said, you know, I'm running out of tracks now, because
yeah.
I kind of like, I only took about 40 odd tracks, so he did half an hour, but they came on and they rocked the place, to be honest.
Yeah, no, I've heard great reports. Unfortunately, I wasn't there because we were the Paradigms were playing at the 100 Club.
Yeah,
in London. But the I've heard great reports from everyone who went down. Said it was a fantastic night, and you know, we've had a lot of messages saying you know, get them back. So we certainly will do. They play with everyone. Haggis Horns are they're top notch, to be honest.
Yeah, but the Funk Nation thing is going to be a kind of a regular kind of thing, isn't it?
Yeah, so it's every couple of months we do. I mean, we've had Smooth and Terrell, we've had obviously the Cray Charles from Console Club back in October. That was a
yeah.
sellout night.
Yeah.
And we've got Grandmaster Flash on the 20th of December. So that's a week after Aswad. We've got Funk Nation presents. Well, it's Funk Nation and a couple of other promoters presents Grandmaster Flash. So he's on tour in the UK, and we've managed to get him to Leicester, which is really exciting.
That's amazing, isn't it? Really, he's absolute legend.
Yeah. he is. Yeah, I mean, it was great to have Craig as well. He's a great character. Obviously, he's a big name as well. He's just gone on. I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here. I know, unfortunately, he had to leave because of the sad death of his brother. But he's Mr. Funk and Soul at the moment. And to follow that up with one of hip hop's founding fathers, really, and the guy who invented scratching, really, on vinyl decks. I mean,
yeah.
He's getting much bigger than that.
And for this gig with Aswad and Co, are you preparing in any special way?
Yeah, I mean we're getting the show very kind of slick and very so that it flows well. We sat down in the week and we had a lot to do recently. We were obviously backing Stranger and Patsy, Jamaican original blue beat artists at Skarmouth and the 100 Club. So we did it where we did our own set for 45 minutes to an hour, and then they'd come on and do their set. So we had a lot of work to do in terms of learning their tracks and making sure that was all tight, because we had very limited rehearsal time with them. But I mean, both those gigs went absolutely fantastically, and I want to thank Club Scar for putting us on at the 100 Club and Skarmouth for having us on the Friday. So now our attention's turned to Aswad, and we're going to make sure that we've got a good mixture of kind of songs in the set, some rock steady stuff, some Scar. We want to bring something different to the table. You've got Dawn Penn on the bill, obviously,
yeah,
as well. So I
yeah.
think all in all, it'll be a fantastic night.
Yeah, it should be as well. Actually, I'm trying to line up another track, so I'm going to think of another question to ask you. What about new recordings? That's the other thing I was going to ask you, because I know you've you've talked about it, but you're getting on.
Yeah, we've got a date for the 7th of February, which we're pretty much on track for at the moment. Maybe a little bit behind schedule, but not too bad. But it'll be February, March time that the next album comes out. The next album's going to be a lot more kind of representative of the live show that people see today.
Yeah.
So it's gonna feature tracks with Pamela Moo as well. She's doing two tracks on the new album.
Yeah, she's a good singer. She is.
It's a nice collaboration we've got with her. She's one of the group now. You know, she's one of the team. So it's going to feature tracks with her and Sweet and Dark. It's going to be called, and we've got a lot more kind of resource going into this album. So expect to see it around a lot more and sort of played on the radio. We're also making inroads into Europe at the moment as well.
Good.
Sort of Spain and Germany primarily. So that's all we're kind of hotting up for next summer. So really exciting time.
Okay, Gay, thanks for coming on the phone at short notice. So
no problem, John.
I managed to find Hold Me Girl, actually, so we'll play that as well.
Oh, there you go. There's a track from the new album.
Yeah, there you go, you see. All right. Okay, Gary, I'll look forward to seeing you. I'll try and get down a week on Saturday. I'll put in my diary now so I don't get it mixed up with this Saturday.
Thanks a lot, John. Cheers.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. Yes, I feel the loving when you hold me, girl. You're gonna give me loving that you told me, girl. And let me show up the reason I told me, girl. And when you're down to down, I make you call me, say yes. One feel it when they're falling, girl. And when I take your loving and you hold me, girl. You're gonna put your hands up to the ceiling, girl. And make you wear the clothes that are revealing, girl. Yeah. Something of my girl, I can't repeat it. Hey, but don't you worry, we can take it slow. Well, oh, you make me hotter than a volcano, and you know what's soon that the lava flow in the dark seat heart gonna make you know what I've got in mind.
From the new album, as Gary said, Paradise there, and Hold Me Girl, and don't forget they're appearing a week on Saturday. I misread my phone there. With the likes of Aswad, Dawn Penn and Echo Marley at a place called Street Life in Leicester. Check it out if I've grabbed tickets, I think, fairly quick. All right, we're going to change from reggae to rock now because we've got a little bit of a band called Skam. They're a big band as well. Let's hear a bit of a track. And then we're going to hear Kevin Gaughan speaking to the band. They've got a new drummer. We'll find out about what effect that's had on the band itself.
Hi, I'm here with Skam in Leicester's O2 Academy, and they're just about to play their last gig of the year. Welcome, chaps.
Yep. Hi, guys.
Hello. Hey.
Hello. Right, we've got Steve, lead guitarist and singer, and then we've got Neil, new drummer.
Yes.
Excellent. And, of course, Matthew coming up the rear.
Yeah.
As always. Why is that funny?
You've had a bit of a band change this year, haven't you? Or personnel change, I should say.
We have indeed. We were on the road in August, and Ray, our drummer, decided to leave the band. So
that's a shame. He's been with you for donkey's years, hasn't he?
Yeah, we were gigging with Ray for about 4 or 5 years. You know, things started to really pick up for us in 2012. So from that point, you know, you're looking at 60, 70 gigs a year, a lot of hard work, you know, the usual rubbish. He really was, you know, a major part of the outfit for that time. But
it was all getting a bit too much for him. Family life.
Things happen. I mean, we're still friends. It was just a case that he said he can't drum anymore, and that was that.
That's a shame. And then along comes Mr. Neil Hill.
Yeah.
Mr. Hill, Hill's Steve Hill's brother.
Yeah, the younger, more attractive Hill.
Now, you used to play in the Furies, didn't you? Are the Furies still going, or...?
No, it was kind of good timing for me, because the Furies finished in the summertime, and we weren't sure whether we were going to carry on, because Joe, our guitarist, moved to London. And then I was kind of thinking about some new bands anyway, and then all this kicked off with the boys, so it was good timing for me just to step in, really.
And you just come back from your first tour with the band, I guess, because you've just done a UK-wide tour, haven't you, including Wales. So that's like jumping at a deep end, I guess.
Baptism of fire.
That's it. How did it go? How did it go, gents?
Neil's done really well. I mean, he's really picked up the mantle, and we really did throw him in at the deep end, you know, because... we rang him up and asked him if he wanted to come down with us when we were supporting Airborne, which he stepped up to the plate, and he did those shows in August. And then we did the tour this last month, and we, you know, me and Matt take it a bit for granted, but we just kind of said to him, you know, you're in now, so we've got these, like, you know, 15 dates that we're doing. You got to get it sorted, get on it.
Well, the boys have been doing it for years, you know, juggling work with gigs.
That's the thing, I mean, driving over to Wales to do a gig and then come back and go to work the next day, that must take it, and then go to another gig the next day after that, it must take it out of you.
It's just the way it is, and you just get accustomed to it, really. I think you just, you know, our bodies are used to eating shit food, drinking loads of beer, and not having a lot of sleep. I just think that's the way it gets, you know, gets, because it has to, just the way the industry is at the minute.
Okay, so let's play one of your songs now, Peacemaker. This is one of your newer songs, isn't it? Do you want to tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, Peacemaker is our latest single. It comes out on December the 1st. We've done a video to go with it. We thought we'd try and do something a little bit different with this video. The last few videos we've done quite, you know, some high budget type stuff with actors and all that kind of thing. But we wanted to do something really rootsy and really quite basic. So we...
Why the title Peacemaker?
Peacemaker is the name of the album, so it's the title track off the album. So it follows the theme. Well, when we were thinking about the album, thinking about things, you know, like themes and stuff that we were writing about, some of the songs seem to always be about a particular conflict, so like conflict with the wife or conflict with your own morals or anything like that. And so this idea of Peacemaker came about where... you could kind of like keep the peace, but with very, very loud guitars.
Right, I like the sound of that. Okay, well, here's Peacemaker by Skam.
I wanted to show you. Show you something that I feel inside. I wanted to own you this time. I've been insulted. Nobody wants me. You
the O2 Academy with Skam. Skam, of course, are about to play. Well, they're about to play. They're about to headline tonight's set. Are you looking forward to that, chaps, or is that a silly question?
We always look forward to gigs. That's why we do this. Gigging, playing live is what you do it for. You know, there's a lot of crap that goes along with what we're doing this. So to get on stage and actually stick your tongue out and get your head banging is what it's all about.
Oh, you like sticking your tongue out on stage?
I do.
Excellent to watch. You guys have had a pretty tremendous year as well, haven't you? Last time I saw you was, I think, here, and you were getting signed up or something?
That's right. We've had a great year. This time last year we got picked up by Off Your Rocker Records, who really came on board and have been a really good platform for us and really helped us out in getting us out there and playing to some new ears. And yeah, it's been great. And we've done loads of cool stuff this year, like off the back of putting out that second record, building the profile, getting both around the country. We've done three tours this year.
Yeah, done three UK tours. We were just saying before, weren't we? We're looking at, I think it's 78 gigs we've done this year, which ain't bad.
No, and you managed to get a new album out as well.
Yeah, new album out. We've picked up some great press. You know, it's great to be reading album reviews in the likes of Classic Rock, Metal Hammer, Kerrang, Power Play. So we've had a very eventful year.
So it took you about 10 years to get the first album out, didn't it? And about, 1 year to get the second one out. Do you think you're picking up momentum now?
Well, the thing was, before we released the album early 2012, and before that, it was like any local band, you're just kind of bashing around Leicester doing the do, but we kind of realised that we were actually half decent, so we thought we'd make a record. We thought we'd make a record, and really, it's, you know, I know like Skam's history is quite long. Me and Steve have been in bands for far too long, but Skam's history for me really starts around January 2012, because that was the time we got on tour with the Answer, went on tour in March, and from that point we've not really looked back, have we?
So you reckon it is gaining momentum then?
Oh, definitely, without a doubt. You know, some of the things we've done this year, played some really good festivals. We played Steelhouse last year. This year, going out playing Hard Rock Hell in Wales, which we
did. Right. That's a big gig as well, isn't it?
And the reception there was amazing as well, wasn't it? And
these festivals are great because you've just got 5,000 dedicated rock fans. But it's just kind of nice to get that appreciation. I mean, next week we're headlining stage two at Planet Rockstock Festival.
Wow.
Now, again, a couple of years ago, Planet Rock wouldn't play one of her records.
So that's the radio channel, Planet Rock.
That's right.
Oh, wow, I listen to that all the time.
And now we're headlining one of their festivals. Wow. So it kind of, it's nice. I think it's nice to get that appreciation and, you know, people dig what we do.
So you'll be getting some airplay on Planet Rock then, will you?
Indeed.
All right. Yeah,
we're kind of featured in the advert, I think, aren't we, already?
Yeah.
That's kind of cool.
Brilliant, I'll listen out for that. Okay, then, what about plans for the future? Are you taking some time out, like most bands do, around Christmas, New Year?
That was the plan. I mean, we've been having a bit of a chat what we're going to do next year. We'll probably have, you know, a couple of weeks off at the start and then just pick it back up again. We've got a few things in the pipeline, a few festivals. We're looking at booking again, tours. We're looking at doing quite a big tour in July.
More of the same.
Yeah, pretty more of the same, but hopefully keep pushing.
Bigger and better venues and bigger and better bands are supporting. Well, you've already pretty much supported one of the best, haven't you? The Answer, so so I suppose the next step is to do a headlining tour.
Yeah,
and to bigger and better venues.
We'll just keep pushing and try and play bigger and better venues to more people that hopefully kind of get what we do. It's all you can ask for, isn't it?
Brilliant. Now the next song, chaps, Holy City. Now, Peacemaker, Holy City. You're getting a bit religious or something, or just want to make peace with the world?
Yeah, Holy City's written about, like, problems in the Middle East, you know, with, like, I mean, it's quite deep, like Israel and Palestine and all the crazy stuff that's going on, because these guys used to live together in peace and, like, actually like each other, and now
it makes me laugh when you talk about
and now they're not. So yeah, it's crazy kind of situation they've got over there.
We're getting old, you know.
We are. I wouldn't guess it by a stage show.
We're getting a little bit old, and so it's only there's only so long you can, like, write songs about boobs and beer, you know. Sometimes you have to look
and lesbians
look a bit deeper, you know.
Yeah. I'll take your word for it.
Yeah.
Speaking about lesbians, actually, You're not finishing off tonight with one of the old classics, are you?
Well, I don't know. That's a weird song, isn't it? We tend to keep that in the vault now for very special occasions.
You'd make an old man very happy.
I mean, I don't know if that's coming out
of several.
It's a Leicester show.
It is a Leicester show. It is.
I knew you wouldn't give me a direct answer. I knew you wouldn't. I'm gonna have to wait. I know.
Steve's gonna get carried away.
But we don't. I hope so.
We don't. We haven't written a set. We don't know what we're playing. Right. Really.
It's random.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just whatever I'm feeling like.
I'll tell you what, chaps, I can't wait to see you. Anyway, it's been great. Thank you very much for being interviewed. And we've got Holy City now by Skam.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you. Nice. Cheers, Steve.
Jumping, I think he's recovered. Skam there, and Holy City, and of course they played their last gig of this year, last week at the O2, and Kevin Gaughan was with them. I could hear that track as well. You can check them out online, as I've just been doing, actually. I've just been checking out online about the next group we're going to talk to. Formal warning, we're going to play a little bit of the track, and then I'm going to talk to Ash. The track is called Twisted. I think I played this a few times, actually, if it will play. Yes, it will. Okay, it's a bit of it. It's a local music show with John Sinclair and Kevin Gaughan. So come, we're hanging around. I think it's Now, if you want to hear the whole track, stay tuned, because I want to keep playing it now. It is a good track. Anyway, we'll go back to it and have a whole track in there just a minute, because Ash is on the phone. Hi, Ash.
How you doing? You all right, John?
Yeah, pretty good. You've been to Ireland. What were you doing in Ireland? What was going on there?
Just went for a weekend away, so got to watch some loads of live music. It was brilliant.
Okay. What sort of things did you watch?
It was sort of folk cover bands, really, most of it. But it was great, you know, they were playing out on the streets, and I did see one unsigned band over there. I think they were called K West, playing in the middle of the street, and they were amazing. So yeah, live music's definitely alive and kicking over there. So
now you had a big gig in Liverpool. There's some great photos of people on the bus going up to watch you as well. It looked like they all had a good time. So talk us through it.
Yeah, I mean, basically it was for a company called Jar Music. And what it was like a music showcase. We went there a couple of months ago because we heard about the company puts live shows on and there can be potential for labels to be there watching. And they asked us to play the main stage of Academy Liverpool this time after watching us last time. And yeah, so we got a coach on and tried our best to fill it. And we went up there and had a good time. Yeah, it was all right.
In fact,
quite a lot of bands.
Yeah, I was going to say, it was very nice of you to ring me and ask me to go. I would have done, but I think I had something on.
No problem at all, mate.
It was one of those things where I was all right, you know when people invited you things in and you can't go, you're kind of like, oh, if only it was a different day and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
So I wanted to know what it was like because, you know, I could have been there.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good day. There was a lot of bands, to be honest. On this second one, there was quite a lot of bands on. So, yeah, it wasn't like we didn't get as much time on stage at this show, but hopefully it was just one of them days. But we're hoping to get some more road trips together soon.
Okay, you're going to get feedback on how it went on that then from the companies that sent out people to watch you. How is it going to work from that point of view?
Yeah, we had to take 4 or 5 CDs. There were a couple of industry people there that watched us. We've had the thank you email so far, and they've said they're going to be in touch. So we're just waiting. You get sort of like a school report off them after every time you play for them. we did last time, and we're just waiting for the ones to come through this time. So it should be all good.
I mean, but this year has been good for you, hasn't it? Generally speaking, you've had some good gigs to play.
Yeah, to be honest, we have. We've been very fortunate in the gigs we've had this year, as in, like with the Leicester Music Festival, Glastonbury, which is always great, and then these couple of Liverpool shows at the academies, and in between that, we've sort of had our own headline shows. So we have had a pretty good year gig-wise. My personal opinion now, I think we need to lock ourselves away for a couple of months and get a new album written, because I think we've been playing the music that we're playing now for a very long time, so I think it'd be ideal if we can just get ourselves locked away and get some new music.
Yeah, I think it's a kind of time of year when bands start to think about doing that. Anyway, I've just had a band on earlier said pretty much the same thing, that they're starting to work on new material for next year, and I think that's a good thing to do every so often anyway, isn't it?
Oh, definitely, especially over the winter, you know, and Christmas certainly, because sometimes the drinks are flowing, and if there's a guitar in the room, you normally come up with something that you're not expecting, so it can be good, yeah.
Are there those members in the band in particular who got the ideas, or how does it work in your band?
We used to get together sort of every Thursday and have an acoustic session round one of the band's house, so we'd always sort of meet up on a Thursday and sort of say, oh, that's the day, we'll have a bit of a drink and have an acoustic session. We've not done that for a while, but I think that was absolutely vital in writing the first album. And since that stopped, obviously the new music has been stopping as well, but it's something we'll definitely pick up again. So
is December quite quiet for you then?
It is. I mean, we've got a couple of gigs booked in. We've got one booked in at the Cookie Jar on the 20th of December, and we're playing at the Pie Bar on Narborough Road on the 12th of December. They're definitely going to be our last gig, like the last gig for a couple of months, I think, just whilst we get a plan together for next year and get some new music written, because I really do. I think not only are the fans ready for something new, I think the band are themselves as well, music-wise. Yeah. We definitely need some fresh material now.
I want to play something different.
Yeah, that sort of thing.
certainly is.
And I guess it's looking at festival options for next year as well, is it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, we've got Glastonbury again. I'm not too sure what's happening with Leicester Music Festival. We had a phone call earlier in the year saying there's potential for us to be on it sort of over the 3 years that they're planning to run it, to see how it went, but we've not heard anything. Normally by now, a festival on that scale would have made a lot of their announcements, so I've not heard anything from Leicester Music Festival. And yeah, it's just, we were meant to be going on tour, but due to sort of finances and funding, everybody getting to Liverpool, that doesn't look like it's going to be happening next year now. But we do, the best thing I think the band can do is sort of sit back, save to get a new album recorded and bring something fresh to the table so we can start getting on radios with new music and start playing gigs with new music, and I think a lot could come from that. I think that's the main ambition for next year, getting a new album out there. I mean, we did have an idea at first to sort of be putting some of the older tracks on the new album, so singles that we've released, but me personally, I just want completely like a new, brand new full album. Yeah. That'd be ideal.
Okay, we'll have to get you in the studio when that appears middle of next year, or whenever that's going to be. Okay, Ash, great to talk to you. Have a good
Thank
Christmas.
You.
Hope the gigs go well. And we'll play the whole of Twisted this time. All right. I'm going to have to turn it
Great
off.
Great stuff. Have a nice Christmas, John.
And you, mate.
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
Bye.
Bye. Worth seeing live. That's Formal Warning and Twisted. Yeah, like that. Do like that a lot, actually. Right, a couple of minutes left. Time to play sport coming up next. Of course, Leicester playing tonight against Liverpool. Come on, Leicester. Come on. Finished with a bit of Doom Into Ruby May and Beneath the Surface. Back next week with more local music between 6 and 7. See ya.
wanted what he couldn't get. Was a man who hated his own fortune, spending his life living through regret. 'Cause he never realized what's important. Beneath the surface.